Hello, this is Latta Brouwer and you are now watching Violin and Viola TV. And in this episode I'm going to make a statement in a very dangerous discussion, which is about shoulder rests, or to have or not to have a shoulder rest. And I would like to give you three aspects so you can determine for yourself if a shoulder rest is good for you, or perhaps no shoulder rest, or perhaps something a little in between, like a little pillow or a shoulder pad or something like that. I'm a little bit in this discussion is sometimes very heated, that people are all the way saying that you must have this shoulder rest, or that you must have a shoulder rest, otherwise you can't play. Or other people are like, the shoulder rest ruined violin playing, blah de blah de blah, and everybody should play without shoulder rest. But if I look at soloists, there are fantastic violinists playing with shoulder rest, and there are fantastic violins playing without shoulder rest. So that proves to me that both is perfectly possible. And it all depends on the shape of your body and what you think plays well for you, what's comfortable for you. And that's very dangerous, I think, if you are making a kind of a fixed statement about this is what you should use, that without seeing a person, without analyzing how someone plays, I think you can't really say something general about this. And that's, I mean, if there was one shoulder rest that was perfect, then everybody would have that, and there wouldn't have been so many brands and so many types. We all have a different body, so we all need different shoulder rests. Perhaps it's just like shoes. And then, if we're making this comparison with shoes, if you only have one pair of shoes and you're wearing it all the time, day in, day out, then it's not good for your feet. It's better for your feet to have a little bit of a change. And I think that you will never find a perfect solution for your shoulder rest or chin rest, but that it's good to have a couple of them at home and to change them a bit. Because it also increases your flexibility. Perhaps you can play sometimes without a shoulder rest and be a little flexible with that. Don't try to seek for the Eureka, I found the ideal shoulder rest, because, you know, it's also good to change it a bit. Well, here are the three aspects that determine if you should play without or with shoulder rest or something in between. Well, first of all, we have stability versus freedom of movement. When I'm playing, I like to move a little bit, and I like to be able to move, to look at my desk partner, to be able to look at the conductor, or if I'm playing in a quartet, to look around at people, and perhaps to the audience. So I must be a little bit free in my neck also, and I don't like to be in the same position all the time. So that's why I have a relatively low shoulder rest, and so I can still, you know, move around. I'm not stuck like in one position. And with most rests, stability and freedom of movement are kind of two barrels. So, for example, there is the Bon Musica shoulder rest, which has a hook, which can be very nice for people who have a violin that slides off the shoulder all the time. On the other side, the disadvantage of the Bon Musica is that it forces you a little bit in one hold and to keep that hold. And it's very solid, it's very stable, but you can't really move around a lot with it. And I think that's its disadvantage, but for some people it works perfect. Then, of course, without the shoulder rest, you have maximum freedom of movement. So the violin can wobble around a bit while playing and stuff, and, you know, your neck is quite free, actually. So that's something you have to search for yourself. With this also, I'm a little bit in the middle, very boring, that I want some stability and some freedom of movement. Then the second aspect is, do you have a long neck or a short neck? If you have a very short neck, you will be probably happier without shoulder rest, or with very low shoulder rest, or perhaps with a shoulder pad. Like this Play On Air shoulder pad, it's inflatable and you can make it higher or lower. It's very soft, so it's a little bit softer than playing without a shoulder rest or playing without anything. And if you have a long neck, you will probably have a bit more need to have a high chin rest, a bit of a higher shoulder rest. otherwise you have to go too much down with your neck and you have a chance on an injury. I don't see a lot of people with very long necks playing without shoulder rests, for example. So that's something that determines it too. Then the third one is, does your collarbone stick out? And I don't mean this literally, otherwise you have to run to the hospital. But I don't know how to phrase it otherwise. If you have not so much fat on your collarbone, then playing without shoulder rests can be very uncomfortable. However, if you have kind of a nice layer there, then playing without a shoulder rest is a bit easier. So try it out for yourself, determine if you want as much stability as possible or as much freedom of movement as possible. Do you have a long neck or a short neck? And is your collarbone covered in a nice layer of fat, or is it kind of sticking out, so to say? I want to warn you again, don't take advice from people who haven't seen you playing and haven't analyzed how that looks and what problems you have with your chin rest and shoulder rest. Just try out, keep thinking for yourself and see what's best for you, and perhaps you can find more than one rest that is good for you and change it around a little bit. So, I hope this is useful to you and I hope it's a valuable addition to the things you've been reading about this. Thanks for watching. Bye!